Right, Aki Kareem, British Boxers, we're here in Masai today. We've got Mr. Ati Shafiq with us.
Yes, cool.
How are you, man? You all right?
I'm good.
Just finished a good, tough session there?
Yeah, it was a good session. End of a good week's training.
No hiding at Champs Camp, is there?
No, you got to get the work done, man.
Tell us about this move to heavy hitters, man. It's a recent thing, isn't it?
Yeah, I've been here about, I think, 3-4 weeks now. I'm settled in well. I'm enjoying the training. It's good hard work and looking forward to getting back in the ring and getting stuck in.
How did the partnership come about? Like, how does that process happen?
Yeah, obviously, I was at the Ingles for 9 years. I've been at the Ingles for 9 years, and I just felt it was time for something different now. Jim was very busy there over in Sheffield, and there was a few options in Sheffield, but I wanted to change. I wanted something different. And a few people recommended Haroon to me. I've through a few friends of friends, so I messaged him. We come up here, had a few sessions, and I enjoyed it. And I'm here now, I'm fighting in 3 weeks, and Haroon will be in my corner.
It's obviously, when you move gyms, it's always a different dynamic with the different lads. How are you sort of fitting in with the different lads and the different fighting styles that they're in this particular gym?
Yeah, just fitting right in, to be honest. Because I'm going to do what I'm going to do anyway, regardless. So I'm still picking up little things from the other fighters. Obviously, when I was at the Ingles, they were all good quality names. But over here, they're probably not as high profile names, but they've still got little things that I can pick up from each fighter here as well. And developing new things with Haroon, you know, Manchester's known for its fitness and grit. So with a bit of Sheffield skill and Manchester's grit and fitness, I think it'll be a good mix.
That's it, man. It's not a War of the Roses this time, is it?
No. It's a nice little, it's a blend. That's the blend, man. Of the roses.
Now, obviously, you're at an interesting point of your career. Yes. You're coming off, Lee Apple was probably one of your best performances, wasn't it?
Yeah, my last fight as well.
Yeah, your last fight as well. So it's... That, and there's another performance that stands out to me as well, which was a really good performance.
Jamie Robinson.
That's right, especially after the build-up as well. But you know, you're at a good position at the minute, aren't you? Yeah. So what's the plan going forward for the next sort of six to eight months?
Yeah, obviously after that Lee Appleyard win, he was the current English champion. The title went on the line because of, obviously, he had a mandatory to box or something, whatever else. But at that time I beat the English champion. So I was back in the gym the week after, looking forward to getting stuck in now, getting into more big fights, and I had to wait around for a while. Ended up getting the Andy Townend fight, to go Doncaster for that. That was scheduled for October. But then I picked up an injury on my elbow in sparring for that fight and needed operating on. So at that time, I think in my head there was a few little things that were bothering me, and I made the change over that period when I had the operation, recovering from that. And now look, Andy Townend, who was scheduled to box, is fighting for the British title. So to me, that shows I'm not far off that. And that's, I'm fighting in 3 weeks, a six rounder. And then hopefully I want to be back in big fights, eliminate for the British title. And my plan for this year is to win the British title.
Yeah. Now obviously you talked about developing and stuff, and you have, you know, you've sort of evolved in your career. Because I mean, obviously there were some times where you got ups and downs.
Yeah, 100%,
you've been caught cold once.
Yeah.
But you've learnt a lot from that. So how do you ensure that sort of those sort of things, the mistakes from the past are put right, so to speak?
Yeah, exactly. That's the mistakes that have been made. They were addressed at the time, and I changed what I needed to change at that time to make sure they wouldn't happen again. And the thing with me was I still know where I'm heading, so the little ups and downs, they're going to happen. Some people have downs outside of the ring. Luckily, outside of the ring, my life's good. So I had the little tests in the ring. I've come through them, and now, off my last performance, I'm on a high, and I want to make sure I stay flying now. I don't want to be hitting no more speed bumps. So I made the change that needed to be done at this time, and now I'm looking forward to pushing on and moving forward and winning titles.
And people can see you next out in February, can't they? You're out in it.
Yeah.
Is this one's not a title fight?
No,
this is more a sort of tune-up sort of thing, isn't it? Tell us about this.
Yeah, I'm fighting February 15th, Adam Etchers and Richard Poxon putting on a dinner show over at the Double T Hilton in Sheffield. There's me on it, there's Cash Ali, Waleed Din, and Shaquille Thompson. So it's a nice little show, four fights. It's just, I think I'm just fighting in a six rounder just to get the rust off. Get used to my new training system, the new trainer in the ring and in the corners there, and then push on after that and hopefully get into some big fights. Managed by Dave Corderlam as well. So hopefully with that link up, I'll be getting some good opportunities and big fights.
Yeah, well, obviously that's platforms. A high-profile guy there for you to pull some strings, and I'm sure you'll be on some big stages there.
Yeah, exactly. No, that's the reason we're signing with him as a manager, because he's in there with the best promotional company in the world, which is Matchroom, I believe. And obviously he works hard for his fighters. He's done a good job with Jordan Gill, obviously Fowler, training and managing them. But I think
didn't do bad with Tony Bellew either.
Yeah, didn't do bad with Tony either. But yeah, I think at this time I'm ready to fight anyone now. So if the opportunity has come and I'm prepared, I'll get the preparation, I'll be ready to fight. So I'm not looking to say no to any fight at the moment.
Yeah. Obviously your style's always been a real good boxer mover, slickster sort of thing. You know, working with Haroon now, you know, there's different things to work on. You'll probably be looking at sitting down on shots more, etc. Are you looking forward to sort of learning the new stuff?
Yeah, exactly. You know, with Haroon still is a boxing trainer. Just Manchester, normally, you know, for Manchester Greek, you know, you come forward, you throw your bombs, body shots, whatever else, but Haroon's still slick and I like his defensive work. With me, there's been a little bits of holes in my defence that we need to work on, and I feel with Haroon now working on them, sort of making them improvements that need to be made, I'll become a complete fighter.
So big 2019 coming in.
God willing, that's the plan, working out in the gym. Looking forward to getting stuck in now.
All right, man. Well, it's good to catch up, and obviously definitely. Now you're around the corner from my house.
Yeah, pop in whenever.
Then I'll be seeing you more.
100%.
All right, man. Take care, man.
Respect.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.